Hello, mysterious person behind the screen, and welcome back to another Steelbook unboxing. It's the Series 8 Steelbook, a late unboxing, because I forgot this was coming out. I completely forgot that this was coming out at all, and I suddenly started seeing people receiving theirs the other day, and I sort of went, oh shit. I missed the pre-order. I completely missed the pre-order, and I could only find it on one site, and that was def.com. Who I've never ordered from before, but I've heard good things. They were like £10 more expensive than everywhere else, but it was sort of a last resort, and I guess that'll teach me for missing out on pre-orders. It's not like me. I'm usually very on the ball with these things. But anyway, Series 8 is the next one in the Steelbook range. I believe the art is by Sophie Cowdrey again. So without further ado, let's unbox this, and we'll take a look at the Steelbook in more detail. So here we go. Here is the Steelbook in hand, and I have to say, it looks a lot nicer in hand than I think it does on an image. The image, when this was revealed, I sort of thought, yeah, that looks pretty cool, but nothing, not one of my favourite Steelbook artworks, but actually in hand, and you sort of catch it in the light, the scribblings, the Doctor's sort of drawings in the background, that it really comes through when you catch it in the light, and it kind of shines, despite the fact that it is still a matte finish, but there's a lot of cool like details in the light. So yeah, that's actually a lot better in person than I thought it was going to be. That's really, really good. Spine, Doctor Who Series 8. Back there, bloody Clara. I believe this should be just a re-release of the same discs that were in the... Oh, there's a leaflet there. We'll look at that in a minute. That was in the original release. Should be anyway, which I do have. I did a review about 6 years ago now when it first came out, or 7 years ago now, of the BBC Shop. Remember that? BBC Shop exclusive limited edition where you press the button and the TARDIS makes a noise. Mine doesn't work anymore, so it's nice to upgrade to a kind of a nicer edition. Don't go and watch that video. It was me as a 13-year-old kid, so my voice is insanely squeaky in it. But hey, anyway, let's look at the back. It's enough of me rambling. Yeah. That looks really, really nice. Really, really cool there. Not one of my favourite series, Series 8, but still pretty cool. Before we open it up, let's have a look at the leaflet. Yep, going for the theme of using the old promo pictures there. And yep, there's a disc-by-disc breakdown. Looks pretty much the same as the old release. So we'll open this bad boy up. And, oh, come on. There we go. Stacked discs once again, but interestingly they appear to have made new labels for the discs with the new BBFC logos and new artwork. So actually I'll get my original set out now just to kind of compare the discs and their artwork. So you can see here, these are the original discs. So we got disc one with Deep Breath, Into the Dalek and Robot of Sherwood. Appears to be they're using the same images, as you can see there. It's just they've got that kind of purple sheen to them now, and of course the new BBFC logos. Yeah, there's disc four there with the old version and the new version. Does appear to be exactly the same images, just with the new kind of colour scheme to fit with the steel. But can I must say, I do really like the purple colour scheme on this steel. I think it fits it really, really nicely. But yeah, we will take the discs out and I'll show you the inside artwork. So yeah, as with all these steel books, they for the inside artwork, they use a promo image from the series. In this case, it's that kind of infamous publicity shot of them in front of the Thames and Big Ben and everything. So yeah, pretty cool. Kind of nostalgic, because really the first kind of batch of reviews I did was for Series 8 as it was coming out, and I reviewed all the stuff surrounding it way back when it was first airing, and now I'm back reviewing something Series 8 related again, like 7 years later. It's yeah, it's weird, man, but yeah, I hope you've enjoyed this little look at the Steelbook. You've probably seen it around quite a few times already, because I'm very late to party on this, but hey, that'll teach me for missing out on pre-orders. But yeah, I was very happy with the service I received from Def. It came quite quickly, very nicely packaged, so yeah, I have no complaints there, and it's you know, really nice Steelbook. The gap is closing. I only need one more Steelbook now and I'll have every modern Doctor Who series in Steelbook form, and that's Series 9. As is the case for a lot of people, they missed out on Series 9. I missed out on the Series 9 Steelbook. I got the standard release, which is nice enough, but yeah, I just, hopefully they re-release that, because I would just love a re-release of that new artwork with the, you know, I don't really care if it's the new artwork or they just recycle the old artwork and put the new logos on. Really, just, I couldn't give a toss. I just want a Series 9 Steelbook in the collection, even though it's my least favourite series, just to fill that gap so I can have a consistent, solid run of Series 1 to 12 in Steelbook form. That would just be amazing. So, yeah, I'd really hope they release Series 9. I do think they will, because a lot of people have missed out on it and are interested in getting it, but I guess we'll have to see. Time will tell. Time will tell. So I hope you enjoy this. Like, subscribe, comment. I'll see you on the next one. Take care now.